Well, here comes a fabulous boat. She's called Dorset. She's a 70-foot traditional stern narrowboat. Quite a young one. She was built in 2017 by Tyler Wilson and fitted out by Finesse Boats. I've always wanted to see a Finesse boat after seeing them at Crick from the outside, and I've never been in, and I can tell you now, they do not disappoint. She was last blacked in 2021, June. That was epoxy two-pack blacking, so that's good for many years to come. She had six new anodes put on her when she was blacked. Lovely cratch cover, very good condition. The paintwork's in really good condition. You can see that as we're walking down the boat. And there's an awful lot of boat to see. I'm going to enjoy showing you. A couple of pigeon boxes on the roof there. They've got storm covers on at the moment. Five side hatches on this boat, all with glazed inner doors. She had a write-up in the Canal magazine, this boat, and it was regarded as one of Tyler Wilson's best ever hulls. There's a view from the helm. She does have a bow thruster. It's a hydraulic bow thruster, so you can use that for as long as you like. A couple of cup holders there. That plank just pulls out and down into the stern cabin. The stern cabin itself is 4 feet long. A few cupboards. This one got squirreled away some mooring equipment. There's a lot more navigation equipment in the lockers in the well deck, actually. All lovely woodwork. Three drawers here for bits and pieces. Storage under there. There is landline hookup back and front of the boat. It's always useful. Electricity in here. That's a 3.5 kilowatt master volt inverter charger. It's all operated from that touchscreen panel just to the left of the inverter there. It's a very clever boat. Mooring pin in there. And in here's a generator. It's a 7 kilowatt Cummins Onan generator, which is behind the panels there at the bottom. If there's too much demand on the inverter, the generator automatically kicks in. It's very clever. It's also a galvanic isolation transformer. There's the generator. 7 kilowatts, so you will not be short of 230 volts on this boat. You've got the generator, the inverter. There's portholes throughout into the kitchen. It's 10 feet long. See those pigeon boxes? You can just see the mood lighting in there, LED strip lights around. Worktops in here are Corian. The floor throughout the boat is Carndine Fresco Light Oak. That's an integrated 230 volt fridge. The appliances are mainly Miele or Miele, I don't know how you pronounce it, but generally regarded as high-end quality from Germany. Plenty of cupboards, lovely sink. And here's a little cupboard for cups and glasses and things. They're the inner doors I mentioned for the side hatches. There's two side hatches in the galley, one either side. There are the lights. All the lights on board are LED. Head height is 6 foot. 6 foot four and a half, actually. This is Miele, or the four-burner gas hob. It's an electric oven as well. A Miele electric combination fan oven. There's the Neff washer-dryer. And the oven's under here. The boat's immaculate, honestly. Beautiful. Little drawer under here. Plenty of cupboard space. And there we go. Plenty of preparation surface. And this is ingenious. I love this. Pull this out. The whole unit comes out to reveal a freezer. It's a 230 volt LEC freezer. It's such clever use of space, that. Battery go. Love it. Right, the dinette area is next. 6 foot 5 inches long, another pigeon box over. There's a lot of storage under the benches. This obviously converts into a spare double bed. It's a Pullman style arrangement. There's storage under there. And another little trick. It's a boat that keeps on giving. Those legs aren't your usual legs for these tables. Under here is a button. and you could electronically adjust the height of the table to suit, or all the way down to make up the bed. Super easy, just like that. And another little trick is that the angle of the backrest can be adjusted to suit your comfort. Teddy bear's going for a little ride. There's another side hatch at the dinette to give you a lovely view while you're dining. And the saloon is next. 8 feet, 8 inches long. Lovely radiators. Television there. It's a 24-inch Samsung television with storage unit underneath. It's so well looked after, this boat. That's a internet router. Onboard Wi-Fi, I think, was the brand. A couple of super comfy armchairs with a footstool. And into the spare bedroom, the guest bedroom, I suppose. Plenty of storage above the bed. Portholes throughout the boat, 15-inch, all openable. I've got bungs for all of them as well. This bed is 6 foot 6 inches long, 4 feet wide, but well, both beds are actually, but they do extend very cleverly to 5 feet wide. And the infill mattress for the extra foot is under the back of the bed there in that. Just see the hinges, lift that up, and there it is. There is another side hatch in here, by the way. Bathroom. This is lovely. 6 foot 9 inches long, Corian again on the worktops and the sink. The loo itself is a Sanimarin macerated pump out to a 200-litre tank. The tank is actually under the steps at the aft end of the galley, so there's storage under both of the beds. Good size cupboard in there. And the same in there. Two towel rails in here. And a really good size 900 mm quadrant shower. There's a light over there. I assume it's an extractor fan as well, but I don't know that. Storage under the gunnels there. And then the forward cabin is the main bedroom, I suppose. 8 feet 9 inches long, storage over the bed, shelves at the end, plenty of storage underneath. And behind those drawers, of course, another lovely radiator in here. I haven't mentioned the central heating. It's a 10 kilowatt diesel fired bubble PJ Max central heating system. Supposed to be really good. Serviced in June this year. That can be operated remotely. So you can, if you've got the app on your phone, you can get the heating going and the hot water ready for when you arrive. Hot water is heated by the engine, the central heating, or there is also an immersion heater on board. Look at it, lovely woodwork. The fit out's stunning, I must say. And the well deck, 4 feet 4 inches long, lovely dining area, glazed cratch board, storage under the lockers either side, and the water tanks under it. It's huge, stainless steel, 850 litres. Glazed front doors. There we go, more mooring equipment and the hose. There is an anchor on board actually, with rope and chain. That's in this locker here. Another landline in there. Oh, Billy's being thorough with the camera on the well deck. Lovely table actually, nice inlay. And back through the boat we go. Another side hatch in here, by the way. It's got a 6 domestic batteries, 120 amp hours each. It's 24 volt system. There's also a starter battery and a starter battery for the generator. This just oozes luxury, this boat. It does have a bow thruster. It's hydraulic. I think I mentioned that actually. We'll have a look at the engine when we go out. But it's a Beta 43 with a hospital silencer. And I have to say, it is super quiet when you're driving this boat because the engine is. Not only has it got the silencer, it's cocooned. She was last serviced in September 22, but that was only 15 hours ago. So it's not done, hardly done anything since. And we'll have a look at the engine bay in here. Just turn around. Under here, they quite easily come up those boards, and there we go. There's the cocoon. There's not a lot to see, to be honest, but it's super clean and tidy in there. And there we go. Absolutely stunning boat. That's Dorset. For further photographs, fully downloadable colour brochure and the price, go to our website, www.rugbyboats.co.uk.